were just reminiscing, talking about Mama and what good memories we had. And one of us mentioned the Nap Fairy, and then it was like the light bulb clicked on and like, oh my gosh, she was suckering us into going to sleep. And so we decided it worked so well on us that we decided to bring it to life for everybody. So that's when we started our journey of hunting for an author, an illustrator, and somebody to make our pillows. The whole journey of that.
The Collaborative Entrepreneur.
Okay, guys, welcome back to The Collaborative Entrepreneur, the show where we aim to build partnerships in order to grow our businesses and relationships. I'm your host, Tracy Currington, and probably you and I both have all wanted to delve into the mind of someone who appears to be doing some great things and going some pretty amazing places. And we're interested in learning from their experiences, and this is the right place for that attitude right there. And so today I'm going to be taking, once again, I've invited guests that we've had on before. They're twin sister entrepreneurs. They're growing their real estate business, and they've got other exciting things that are going on. And this will be a special edition. It's my belief that as entrepreneurs, that when we come to the marketplace, there's got to be something that stands out about us. There's something usually distinct, something that distinguishes us from the rest of the noise out there, so that we're not more or less vanilla ice cream. And what I like to think is the distinguishing mark is credibility. Credibility is so important. There's so many components that go to making an entrepreneur credible in the marketplace. One thing is just be consistent. I mean, you know, show up. You got to be there and be the same way. Also, you're offering quality service or the best of the best type products or something like that. Maybe it's also you're utilizing testimonials that, you know, other your raving fans are saying this and that about you, and they got a great experience with you is one way to establish your credibility. Also, you can establish credibility just by building trust. And all of that comes from consistency, testimonials, and so forth. But the last thing that I believe that you can build credibility with is by showcasing your achievements. And I know it's tough for entrepreneurs to often, most of us, struggle with tooting our own horn, with letting everybody know what we've done. So what I've done in my business, and I've got 8 kids, and I pastored the church for 18 years, and I've got 2 books in editing. I'm like, there's just so many achievements, and entrepreneurs are pretty amazing people because they're willing to take more than normal risks. And the guests that I have on the show, returning guests, the property twins that have their real estate company, they also have a very special thing that they've instituted through their business, through their life together, and collaborated on a project. And I think it's brilliant. I can't wait to show you all that we have in store for you on this special edition episode. And so I'm going to welcome back Deanne and Diane, the property twins, back to the Collaborative Entrepreneur. Ladies, welcome back to the show.
Hi. Hello, Tracy.
Great to see you guys. And I see you brought some guests.
We did. We brought the characters from our book.
That's awesome. So those that are viewing with us today, both Diane and Deanne have a great story that they've put, and I've got a copy of their book. It's called The Nap Fairy, Nap Fairies Everywhere. And man, it's quality. It's so good. But the cool thing is about this whole thing is it doesn't just come with a book and a great cover and so illustrated so well. It also comes with a pillow. It's got a little card on it. Everything is just marked with, even the tag says Nap Fairy on it. Just so cool. So this is a package deal. We'll make an offer to you about this at the end of the show before the podcast is over. And by the way, it's a special offer just because you're watching this show. It's only going to be offered to you. And so stay tuned for that at the end of the call. We'll share that with you. But ladies, tell me first, this whole story, how did this get to going? I'm assuming that these are characters from the book. So give me a little insight about what's going on with this storyline.
Well, when we were growing up, we have there's 4 of us girls. So we got to spend a lot of time at our grandparents' house, and Mama would be tired from working a full-time job and then 4 little girls. So she was creative in getting us to take a nap or going to bed at night by telling us the story of a Nap Fairy. The Nap Fairy comes when you're sleeping at night or at nap time, and leave something in your nap fairy pocket. So we would lay down and go to sleep and wake up in the mornings and check our pocket. And it might be a vanilla wafer, maybe a Band-Aid or a balloon from the bank. It was not much, but we were thrilled that Nap Fairy cared and came and left us something. So there would be mornings that we would wake up and Nap Fairy hadn't left anything. So of course we would go crying to Mama and say, well, Nap Fairy didn't show up. And Mama was quick to think, oh yes, Nap Fairy came, but she's got something so special this time it won't fit in your pocket. So you girls have to figure it out.
Huh. So we would go to school that day and maybe there would be a new kid at school. And so with our imagination, we would just kind of think to ourselves, oh, the Nap Fairy brought me a new friend today. Or maybe at recess, I would find a butterfly or a roly-poly. Wow. Or maybe today I could run faster or jump higher. And I was thrilled because that's what the Nap Fairy helped me have special powers for the day. It's whatever I needed it to be for me that day. Mm. So it helped us learn that anticipation of sleeping at night, knowing we were going to have something either in the morning or we would have to wait all day trying to figure out what the Nap Fairy left. So it left a good day for us and taught us anticipation, something that kids these days are not getting.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead. Tell me.
I was going to say, we lived this many years ago and we'd forgotten all about it. And then when Mama died about 10 years ago, we were just reminiscing, talking about Mama and what good memories we had. And one of us mentioned the Nap Fairy. And then it was like the light bulb clicked on and like, oh my gosh, she was suckering us into going to sleep. And so we decided it worked so well on us that we decided to bring it to life for everybody. So that's when we started our journey of hunting for an author, an illustrator, and somebody to make our pillows, the whole journey of that.
Wow. So before we get in that journey, I want to come back to Mamaw. Oh, this is pretty cool. What a pretty creative woman to be able to obviously get you to take a nap.
And she had many tricks. Willingly. Yeah.
But there were times
that we would go to her house on a Saturday afternoon and walk in the door and say, hey, Mama, if we take a nap with the Nap Fairy come, and she would just kind of snicker to herself and she would say, sure, go to the front room and grab a pillow and lay down. She would throw a quilt down on the floor. We would all grab a pillow and lay down. And all four of us would go to sleep at the same time. No complaining. Wow. And so, of course, we would wake up and maybe find a vanilla wafer or a balloon from the bank or a sucker from the bank.
Maybe it was a note that says Nap Fairy loves you.
It was just something. Or maybe we would wake up and have to go outside and figure out what the Nap Fairy left. So she was very creative in most everything she did.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was thinking, like, you know, if like the Nap Fairy were, I mean, like, if I had, you know, I laid down and instead of worrying about, you know, my financial troubles, or if I, instead of going, like, because that's a real thing. I mean, some people stay up all night long playing on their phone and the blue light hits them. They can't fall asleep. They need to take some melatonin or they've got to medicate themselves to get to bed. And if they went to bed just believing that, hey, something wonderful is going to come to my life as a result of waking up refreshed. I'm going to be, oh man, the Nap Fairy left me focused today. Like even for adults, I was just thinking, like, how does that apply in a learning lesson? What if you guys, and maybe I'm getting ahead of myself, but since I already started the question, what if you guys thought about, like, the Nap Fairy, like, even now in your own adult life? I mean, like, laying down. Getting a good night's rest, waking up. What has it meant to you now?
Well, I'll tell you on that thought, we have adults. One just on Saturday last week told us that she used an adult bought a set and she uses hers. She puts her prayers in her Nap Fairy pocket at night.
Awesome.
Yeah. Our friend Susan, she is a firm believer
in it. We have had kids that were like 8 or 9 years old when they got their first Nap Fairy pillow. And on her own, she decided that if she would study her lesson at night and lay down and sleep on her pillow and wake up and go to school the next day, it helped her get a better grade on her class. So it's It is. It helps us because we lay down at night, I guess since, you know, for 50 years, thinking of the good things that are going to happen tomorrow. And it was because of the nap berry from all those years ago. We just don't have bad days very often.
Uh-huh. That's just so, I mean, I'm pretty amazed that, I mean, how it reflects. I knew it was a children's book that we were going to be talking about. I did not get the, I thought it was just, a trick to get your kids to go to sleep. But thinking about, like, I was thinking about Lamentations. It talks about his mercies are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. And like, just thinking about where does God show up for your day after a good night's rest? Scripture says, behold, he giveth his beloved sleep. And so like, just connect. I'm just connecting these things together. Like when you wake up refreshed, like what good things has God had for me today?
Absolutely.
Like,
I can't wait to find it.
Yes. Wow.
All day long.
I can't wait to go to bed just because tomorrow's going to be a brand new day.
Yes.
So tell me about that. Let's come back to that journey. And by the way, celebrate all kinds of praises go to your mamaw for her creativity, for bringing this, implanting this into you four girls. And then I mean, now launching it into a book and a package and stuff to help other kids. Tell me about the journey about you guys becoming an author, because from the story that I've heard bits and pieces of, it's not the typical journey of like, I have a storyline, I go to my typewriter, I write it all up, and then I illustrate it, and then I send it to a publisher. I mean, like, tell me that story.
Well, first off, we tried many, many, many times on our own trying to come up with a story or how to write it, and
crayons just don't make a very pretty picture for a book.
Yeah, and so between the words and the
color and pages,
it just didn't work. So we started asking friends. Mm. Who do you know that can help us write a book? Until we found a friend, Leslie, who suggested her aunt, who was an author and a publisher. And so we reached out to her, and it just came to... the author knew a guy that illustrated, and so we really, really lucked out with our illustrator, Kevin Stark. So all of that, while it took a long time and a lot of decisions, we're really happy with it.
Yeah.
The pillows, we thought, well, we can do this.
We can make those.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, turns out we can't. We took sewing classes and we bought a lot of material and tried different sizes and different styles, and we spent a lot of time and tears trying to come up with this, and it was a feat, but we finally got it done.
So did you guys do all the sewing?
No, we hired it all done. Okay. We hired all of it done.
Okay.
We even hired a book designer to design the book.
Wow.
Yeah.
My favorite page is towards the back. You can't see it on here, Tracy, but when you look at your book.
Oh, it's got your mamaw?
Yes. Yeah. This is all about mamaw. Yes. Yes.
Yes. I love that one. I did get to see that in mine too.
That's her.
That's awesome. So, okay. So the, what about the audience? Like, what's the typical age of somebody that benefits from, I mean, probably it's going to be an adult, a grandmother, a mother, a father, somebody that's buying this as a gift. What's the typical age that responds well to it as far as a child?
10 and under.
Yeah, 10 probably. And under. You know, we take our characters and we put on onesies that look like the Mercury's in the book with our weeks, and we take our show to daycares and schools, preschools,
library,
things like that, and do the story for the kids. And we've even had third and fourth and fifth grade kids come in and watch, and they are as amazing as the kindergarten kids.
Oh, that's
so awesome. There's really, well, in fact, last Saturday we did it for a group of
women,
a golf ladies association, and they enjoyed it.
So amazing. That's so amazing. Yeah, that's... That's great. Well, introduce me to the characters. I see a drum. I think I see a guitar. Tell me about the characters.
Well, this is Miss Froggy McGee.
Okay.
She's the singer in the band. The band is called
The Very Odd Band.
Yeah, The Very Odd Band. She's the singer in the band. That's Miss Froggy McGee. And then back here, we have everybody's family has a black sheep of the family.
Uh-huh.
And family, it was our Uncle Gator. So this is Uncle Gator. And then we have the cat who plays the bazooka. And then we have the white sheep. And then the cow playing the drum here.
That's awesome. That's a very odd band, but I mean, the illustrations are awesome. I just thumbed through my book and I mean, those will pop out for children, no doubt. So tell me about the book's theme. Like what is the main idea that's trying to get across? I mean, it can't be like, hey, you know, go to sleep, take a nap, and like good things are gonna, what is the main theme?
So what the funny part is when the author, when we reached out to her to write the book and told her the story, she was on her way to take a trip over to Ireland. And so when she got to Ireland, she was going to relax and think about it. Well, when she got there, she realized that Ireland is where the fairy folklore started. So the story is from Beckham County, Oklahoma, which is where Mamaw is from, where we're from, to County Down, which is the county in Ireland where she went to. So it's based on Oklahoma and Ireland. So that fairies in general, they have different folklore.
So when you're dancing in the forest, with a very odd band, you have to be very careful not to step on a twig inside these fairy forts.
And so that's what they're doing is they're dancing around because a ring of trees is a fairy fort. And that's what the Irish believe, that when you have a ring of trees, that's where fairies live. So you're not supposed to go in and break limbs and step on twigs.
Well, they accidentally stepped on one
in the book, and so it woke them up and they had to come back.
Uh-huh.
So it kind of teaches, you know, a bazooka is an instrument that they play in Ireland. So it's kind of got Irish folklore.
Yeah, that's awesome. And that's Mamaw's heritage?
No, it's the author.
Oh, the author, okay. Yeah.
Good everybody.
Oh wow, that's so great. How long did it take from start to finish? I mean, so some entrepreneurs, I wish I had some credibility. You know, if I had a book, you know, like how cool to be, you know, going, you know, and having this out as this is credibility. This, because everybody knows the work it takes to get into a book, or they, at least they believe there's a lot of work involved in it. For you guys, how long did that process take?
It was right at 2 years to have our book and these pillow in our hand. We had a prototype pillows made before, and then we changed to this prototype and went with this one. But it took 2 years to have the book and pillows in our hand.
Wow.
So we worked hard to get it all done that quick.
Mm-hmm. So what about the times that, like, I would imagine there was frustrating times where you just like, oh man, why are we doing this? You're wanting to give up. What happened? How did you fight through? How did you break through that barrier about wanting to give up? Is this what we should do?
So what we have learned through classes and learning about ourselves and learning about each other is our strengths and weaknesses. And we've learned that when I'm having a lull time, she pulls me up, and when she's having a low time or in a negative funk, I'll pull her out. And so we don't allow each other to stay down for very long. And when one of us was feeling like, oh my gosh, this is overwhelming, I quit, The other one would be, you know,
okay, hand it here, I'll do it. I got it done.
And when we would have to make decisions on what color, what size do you want the book? How many pages do you want in the dust cover? What color thread?
Where do you want these tags? We would, you know, this is a big thing. You know, do you want it here? Do you want it here? And so when it came to decisions like that, one of us would say, I want it like this. And then the other one would be like,
I don't mind because I want this here. Or so it was a big give and takes on a lot of things.
Yeah, that's
but
awesome.
We learned early on that, you know, what really mattered to me didn't matter to her, and what mattered to her didn't matter to me. And so there was no reason to fight over things.
We started out with 22 colors of pillows.
Narrowed down to 7.
22 was a lot.
So my pillow, I got a blue pillow. I can get a pillow with my book in whatever color I want. Or I guess the 7 colors that you offer.
7 colors, yes.
Okay. I get you.
Yes.
Love that.
She's holding the camo right here.
Yeah, this is
And the so camo. The pocket in here has your, you know, I love the, it's so for our viewers, it says, as you snuggle in your bed, soft voices of nap fairies in your head, dream of what you might find in the pocket or outside. Pretty flower, special power. As you slowly fall asleep, the nap fairy will tickle your feet and a note, I hope you find. Words, of course, will be kind. What a treat to go to sleep, wishing you sweet dreams, the nap fairies. And I love that. It has the it has great way to contact them also for our viewing audience. But this pocket, is that where the little treat goes or the nose?
Yeah.
That's so cool.
And all of the pillows
have. Or if it's too big to fit in the pocket, you have to figure it out, Tracy.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah.
So when we put on our little when we put on our show for kids and groups, when we're done and we ask the kids, you know, what are your hopes in your nap fairy pocket? 9 times out of 10, they all yell, I want my pocket to be empty.
Yeah.
Really?
Mm.
Most of the time, they want to
think about the superpowers.
That special.
Making a goal at soccer game or whatever. And so it already gets their imaginations going. Mm.
What do you like? So like you got the finished product. What do you like most about
feedback?
Okay.
Feedback. When a kid, when we're going someplace and we're walking through Walmart and a kid stops us and says, oh my gosh, you're the nap fairies. And they tell us something about it. Or we are somewhere and a mother says, I'm so tired of that ratty pillow. I have to have a new one. Those are the things that mean so much to us, is knowing that they're using them and loving them and creating their memories.
And something that I like best about it is our mamma gets to continue on.
Yeah, legacy.
So now you know our mamma.
I do. That's right. I got a picture of her too.
Yes.
What about the other two siblings? I mean, like, what do they think about this whole journey that you've done in keeping mamma's
We didn't tell anybody. Of our family.
They saw this
for the first time when it was finished.
They didn't know the coming.
Tell me their reaction.
They were shocked, and cried.
Yeah.
Wow, that's special. So okay, so this is a typical question that anybody who's written a book will be asked. This is the typical one. Why should someone purchase the book? Why should they buy the book and read it?
So they can know my mamma.
it really does make a great baby shower gift. Mm-hmm. It's Valentine's.
Birthday.
Christmas. Just a birthday gift. They make great gifts. And it's a lasting memory.
What's that?
Lasting memories.
Oh, hmm. Yeah.
So, you know, instead of putting a whole bracelet in a pocket, if you just put a few beads and let the girl, you know, work
over time to build her bracelet.
I see.
Or instead of putting a package of green army guys in there, if you just put one green army guy in there at a time, or one Lego at a time, then they have to anticipate building the Lego town or whatever. And that's what's important, is that it's not anything big. It's not anything, you know.
It's not a $20 bill.
No, it's more important that it's one matchbox car, not the whole thing. It's the little things.
Yeah.
And that's all the kid wants.
Yeah, it teaches. I love that thought of it teaches contentment in the little things. Like, it doesn't take much. And like nowadays, everybody feels entitled to, you know, big things. And like, you know, I need to have a house and a car because my mom and dad have one. But you're 19, you know, like you don't need that, like all those things just yet. So I can see that those are some great lessons that it would teach. The memories also of doing that. And then just even for me as an adult, just the benefit of getting a refreshing nap or a good night's rest. I'm more focused, I'm more clear-headed. I'm more, it's easier for me to spot the blessings of the Lord around me everywhere. Yeah, I love that. Okay, so what else would you like to share about this, either the journey, about the book, the pillow, feedback that I haven't already asked?
You know, when you start something, finish it, no matter how long it takes. We hear so many people say, oh, I started writing a book, or I want to write a children's book. Well, do it, because that's your legacy. Waiting. You know, when people say, my mother is dying, video her, write her stories down. That's the legacy. We're missing so much, and it's, you don't get to keep that once it's gone.
Right. Yeah, that's good. That's really good. My reminds me, my son, my second oldest son, last Christmas, two Christmases ago, bought my father a book that he had to fill out. And it was like, it had promptings like, you know, what was your first date with grandma? And, you know, what was your childhood like? Just like, it's like 250 pages. And so he wrote the whole thing. He copied it for me and other, and my siblings. And I read it and I laughed, I cried, my heart warmed, just because I got to kind of live in that space of him as a little boy and growing in that. Wow. And I think you're right. I think there's not enough testimonies to our grandparents and to our moms and dads. And so I can see the sentimental value in that.
We get tied up in our day-to-day, rush, rush, rush. You don't know about tomorrow.
Yeah, it's good stuff. Good stuff. Okay, so if you were going to give any advice to, maybe there's an entrepreneur, and I know this was a special edition and everything, but guys that are viewing this right now, these types of things that they're going, that they walk through, that they put themselves 2 years into doing, and all the monetary investment into doing it, all the work that went involved in it, this sets them apart. When they go into like you said, Walmart. They go into Walmart, guys, and some kids come up and like, oh, you're the Nap Fairies. The Nap Fairies. I thought you guys were selling like real estate. Yeah, that's who we are. I was like, it's something that distinguishes you guys, set you apart in the marketplace.
Yeah, we've accomplished so much, so much.
Yeah, we really have.
And I think that's one thing that like, entrepreneurs fail to recognize when they kind of get in the moment and they think, okay, so like, you know, like how did I get leads and how do I do this? There's so much that you've accomplished that just builds credibility. People really, they want to do business with people they know, they like, they trust. And building trust as an entrepreneur, sometimes the credibility component is how you do that. You've got to share with them, hey, I've served this many clients, or I wrote this children's book. Wow, you did? Yeah, it was a 2-year process, a lot of investment. And then, you know, as a way to give back to the community, I go to libraries, I go to book clubs, I go to these, schools, and we read the story and we do the little thing with the animals or whatever it is. Like, that's, oh man, I want to buy a house for them because look what they're doing in the community.
That's what helps fund this.
Yeah, that's so great. So now I want to make sure that I'm not speaking out of turn. I understand that there's a deal for anyone who is watching Collaborative Entrepreneur, the special edition. What is that deal?
we've given it a third price off.
Okay.
So you normally a book and a pillow is $45.
Okay.
And if you mention the Collaborative Entrepreneur on Facebook that you watched it, it's $30 for the set.
$30 for the set.
Mm-hmm. And you get
to pick. And you get what of the seven different colors of the pillow.
Yeah. Right. You can buy additional pillows. If you have four kids, you can buy four pillows and one book. Or you can buy four books. Yeah.
Okay. Wow. That's awesome. So then how do they connect? How do they connect with you guys?
We're on Facebook, the Knapp Fairy.
Okay. The Knapp Fairy on Facebook.
Or through the Property Twins Okay on Facebook.
Excellent.
And you can put our phone number.
And that is?
580-490-6300.
Okay. 580-490-6300.
Yes.
Awesome. Guys, this is awesome. Thank you so much, Diane and Deanne. Thank you for joining me on this call again. This is wonderful. And congratulations to all the work that you're doing to set yourself off in the marketplace, to give back to the community, to share your mamaw with the rest of the world.
Thank you, Tracy.
Thanks for sharing about it.
We love sharing.
My pleasure. And by the way, thank you, listener and viewer, for following me at the Collaborative Entrepreneur. And if you would like to know more about what I do, what I can do for your business, how I can help you, reach out to me, tracy@tmccoaching.org. There's several different ways, several different opportunities that I might be able to serve you. And if that would be a good fit for you, we're like-minded, like-valued, I know that we'll get along just fine. So you can reach out to me then. Until next time then, after the special edition, surround yourself with people just like the Property Twins, just like the Knapp Fairies. Great people who can elevate your thinking and inspire you to dig deep and do more. We'll see you next time on The Collaborative Entrepreneur.
Thank you for watching this episode of The Collaborative Entrepreneur Podcast. Be sure to like and follow and turn on notifications for future episodes launching every Tuesday night at 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. If you're an entrepreneur and want to be on the podcast, you can let us know by emailing us at tracy@tmccoaching.org. Let us know the industry you're in, as well as your biggest wins and learns that you've achieved along the way. If you want to find out how you can work with Tracy in other ways, you can do so on all major social media platforms under 180 Turnarounds. You can also find us on our website at 180turnarounds.com. So until next time, guys, let's win together.